Hi, so this time around I have a very juicy video. Actually, that sounds wrong because it's about murder, as you can see by the title. But guess what? It's a really interesting story. It is about a very interesting woman, actually a grandma that was very, very old. I will give you all the information in the video. So let's jump into it right away. I'm telling you, this is a really, really good story. Really interesting personality of this woman, and I can't wait for you to hear it. So here we go. The real name of the woman is, well, actually I can't pronounce it because it's, I think, Romanian, but it's something along the lines of Anna de Pistonja. Pistonja, I have no clue. Don't lynch me, Romanian people. But people knew her by Grandma Anujka, or in our language, Baba Anujka. So this is her story, let's go. The exact past of Baba Anujka is not 100% accurate, they say. But according to the sources, she was born in Romania in 1838 as a daughter of a rich man. 11 years later, she moved to Vladimirovac, which is a small place in current Serbia. Not far from there, in the town called Pančevo, she went to private school with other kids of wealthy families, but after that she lived in the house of her father. The sources say that she was a misanthrope, I think that's how it's pronounced, I'm sorry. That means that she generally disliked, hated, or didn't have trust in humankind or the behavior and the nature of people. Which explains a lot when you get to hear the rest of the story. Well, now you might wonder what prompted her to be that person. It is believed that a young Austrian military officer was the one to blame because after seducing her, he left and she was left with syphilis. So that is horrible. After that unfortunate incident, she was looking to be alone and she showed an interest in chemistry and medicine. She also spoke 5 languages. Somewhere along the line, she met a man who was much older than her. Out of 11 kids they had, only one lived to get to his 18th birthday. I believe that that child died soon after that as well, but that is not specified anywhere. Her husband then died 20 years into the marriage, and after becoming a widow, she went back to her studies of chemistry. In the part of her house, she made a laboratory just after her husband's death, and she had a reputation of a healer, and she was a herbalist as well, and all of that was kind of like, she became kind of known for that by the end of the 19th century. She would help the women of the farmers with their health, but not only that, she would take the healthy men who were capable of serving in the army, and she would make them sick so they would not be obligated to go serve. Which was very, I chuckle at that, I still do. I think that's a very smart move from somebody. I wouldn't want to go to army. I mean, I don't think I would be faking, you know, some kind of illness, but I would definitely not be trying to make myself sick or anything like that, so that I would be, you know, released off of that duty. But yeah, that's very interesting, because nobody wants to go to war. Who the hell wants to go to war? I mean, if you do, good for you, not really, but... Now, what made her famous, shall we say, were the mixtures that she created, and she called them love potions or magical water. But they were actually just poison, and she gave them usually to the husbands of the wives who asked for it, and then those husbands would die approximately within 8 days of drinking that. Baba Anujka would use arsenic and plant toxins that could not be detected as well. So she knew what she was doing, she knew how to do it. She did it. She did it, people. Her victims were usually men, and a lot of them were young and healthy, which would be suspicious, right? Later in the court, women who would be asked about the knowledge of Anujka's poisonous magical water, they would say that they were not aware of the poison itself, but they rather believed she had some supernatural power that made their spouses die. It is believed Baba Anujka killed between 50 and 150 people. 150. Oh my god. My goodness, this woman was prolific. I mean, she was a prolific serial killer, and I'm like, that's not funny, but I'm laughing because it's crazy. And why I wanted to do this is because recently I watched some serial killer documentaries, and I saw Henry Lucas, who was, you know, claiming that he killed first one, then three, then 100, 300, 600 people, and in the end the question is, did he even kill anybody? And I'm like, who in the Yugoslavian territory back then, or, you know, today Serbia, Bosnia and stuff, and countries of that region, did we have serial killers? Because this is where I live. And then I found her, and she's literally one of the most prolific serial killers ever, not just in our region, just in the world. I only saw like one or maybe two people who killed over that. Of course, the specific number for this woman is not, you know, is not 100% certain, but it's still approximately huge. In the 1920s, Baba Anujka had her salesperson as well. Her name was Ljubina Milankov, and she would seek the possible clients and bring them to her. So she was just selling that poison to whoever she could, and she knew what. But here's the thing, I don't know why she did it. Like, by the end of the story, like, yeah, she was a misanthrope, but I don't know, like, you can't be just that and kill, right? There had to be something there mentally wrong with her, I guess. Or maybe, I don't know, I'm not a psychologist, I don't know. What brought her closer to the police's attention was a woman called Stana Momirov. She was already Anujka's client, and thanks to her help, she killed her first husband, Lazar. Once the woman remarried, uncle of the new husband was a rich man, and he died under the similar circumstances, which was suspicious for the police, and Stana pointed them towards Baba Anujka. Then in 1926, Anujka sold magical water to the one couple who wanted to get rid of the husband's father, who was allegedly violent. He was also an alcoholic. He would beat their kids. And that man died too because of that poisonous drink. And so the police was like, well, let us connect the two dots. This is what, you know, is happening. I don't know how they didn't clock before that, but, you know, they did at one point at least. Because of these two cases, Baba Anujka was brought to the court that lasted a few days. Among the mentioned people, there were other accomplices who knew about what was happening and were contributing to the killings, which is why they were brought in front of justice as well. Now, there was a lot of confusion here. Everyone was accusing everyone, but none of them wanted to take the fault upon themselves, of course. Baba Anujka defended herself by saying how one of the women present in the ruling was one that was actually guilty of the killings, but she only wanted to frame her. Other people said that they were unaware of the poison. They thought, as I said, that Baba Anujka only had supernatural powers that would later kill their husbands and not cure them as they wanted it to happen. Now the funny thing here, if we can say funny, was the fact that Baba Anujka, as someone who killed between 50 and 150 people, only got 15 years in prison, where some other people got a life sentence. Now the reason for, I mean, there is a reason, it's because Anujka didn't actually kill any of them, right? She was only selling the poison. So by that, it, you know, that means that she was only providing the means to kill someone while others were doing the actual killing. So for example, if I sell you the poison, you don't have to use it to kill anybody, which wouldn't mean that I did anything wrong or you, because we didn't. But because they did kill someone, they would get the life sentence. Several other accomplices also got from 8 to 15 years, while two of them, who were a bit younger, claimed that they didn't really know what they were doing, and so they were set free. However, several months later, and the plaintiff again asked for the death sentence for all of them. Baba Anujka was again set for 15 years of prison, only this time she would have to do so-called hard labor. That is the closest I can translate to you. I think that is how it should be translated. Other people would have their years increased to life sentence, and some of them just by a few years, and those two who were set free again. Good for them. And then, just for the conclusion, because this is it, according to one source, Baba Anujka was released 8 years later in her 98th year of life due to her old age. And then I'm thinking, how was she not old when she was 90, but now she's old when she's 98? I don't know, that is crazy to me. And then it says that 2 years later she died in her house in Vladimirovac when she was 100 years old. But according to the other source, she stayed in the prison until the beginning of World War II in Serbia, when German officers would release her from the cell. And if this is true, she was 104 years old when she died. And this would conclude the story of this famous grandma that people call the witch from Vladimirovac. And it was so intriguing to me reading this. You know, I'm not somebody who seeks out knowledge about serial killers on a regular basis, but I am somewhat intrigued by what they did. I mean, most of the people are, I guess. These bizarre cases are usually interesting and crazy in itself. But yeah, this is the story for this video, and I don't know, I hope you enjoyed it. This could be actually a really good TV premise. It really could. And somebody should get in on this. I would if I had the means. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and next time, it's probably not going to be about killers, but it's going to be something fun as well. So join me in the next video, and see you then. Bye.